Hello, Eagles, and welcome back to Art Class. Today we're going to be looking at the work of an artist named Sonia Delaunay. She was a pioneer of a new type of art that used very pure bright colors and geometric shapes, and she was especially fond of using circles. But she wasn't just a painter, she was also a fashion designer, and her designs even were used to decorate a car. To make art like Sonia Delaunay is almost like making your own color puzzle. It's really fun. So let's get started. In addition to your journal or paper, you'll need a straight edge. It doesn't have to be a ruler, anything that you can use to help draw a straight line, a pencil, and something to color with. I'm going to use crayons and watercolor for this demonstration, but you don't have to use crayons and watercolor. Markers would work just fine. You will also need some objects that you can use to trace circles. So collect whatever you have from around your house. You could use yogurt cups, tape rolls, medicine bottles, empty containers and lids, small bowls, anything you can find to make a circle. The first thing you're going to want to do is place the objects on your paper, starting with the largest ones, and trace some circles. I'm starting with three. I wouldn't do much more than that because you'll see that it does start to get complicated pretty quickly once you've made several circles and then drawn lines through them, since each section is going to be a different color. Now, smaller circles inside of the larger ones, and then your straight edge to bisect across those circles, to draw lines through them. Okay, now we're ready for color, and we've created all these different sections, and we're going to make each section a different color. So I might repeat purple, but I'm going to put it somewhere else in the picture so that it doesn't touch this purple. And the reason I'm outlining is that I'm going to use the waxy crayon line as kind of a fence to keep my watercolor in. Now, if you're not using paper that will hold up for watercolor, you could just color the whole thing in with crayons, or you could use something different like markers or colored pencils, and that's fine too. Sometimes it's fun to include a little something unexpected in your art, so I'm shading in one section with pencil. Now we're ready for the watercolor. Water first, a little bit in your pan to make a puddle of color, and then think about maybe even a little bit on the paper itself. You can dip into your puddle of color and just let the watercolor do most of the work. Spread it around gently. You don't have to scrub it into the paper. And if you wind up with too much water on your paper, you can pull it off with a Kleenex or a little paper towel. The crayon lines will help act like a fence to keep your watercolor in its place. Okay, let's go ahead and go from one section to the next, filling each area in with the color that you planned. I'm going to speed this video up, but remember, you can pause it anytime you need to. Thank you. When you're finished with your artwork, be sure to upload a photo. I can't wait to see what you've made. I did want to show you two other versions. I made one just with crayons. As you see here, I still outlined in order to do the coloring in. And I also made one just with markers. I hope you enjoy this project, and I'll see you again soon.